So you've been sending emails to your clients or customers, and they're not responding because your emails are going either into spam or their junk email, and you're not really sure why. Now, there are typically two reasons this happens. It's because of your SPF record being improper or DKIM not set up properly. In this video, we're going to cover your SPF record and how to set that up properly. So come with me and we're going to set that up for you. I want to thank you for coming in. Like I said, in this video, we're going to cover the SPF records sender policy framework. If you're looking for how to set up DKIM authentication, check the description below and you'll find links on how to set up Outlook or how to set up the Google one. But let's go ahead and jump in. And as we do, I do want to remind you guys, you can find us on all the social media platforms. We have Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at NextTechNT. And obviously here, if you do like this video, give it a thumbs up or subscribe to the channel to see more videos like this that help support your business. All right, so let's start off with what an SPF record is. An SPF record stands for Sender Policy Framework. And what that is a DNS entry inside of your domain that says, hey, include these IP addresses. And it tells people outside of your organization that you're allowed to send emails from this specific set of IP ranges. And it just is a first check on almost all of your emails to see if it's spam or not. So for example, you either have an Outlook one or a Google one that says, hey, include all these IP addresses. If it doesn't match your SPF record, then a lot of times this is the most likely cause that your email is going to be sent to spam. So let's go ahead and hop over to the computer and I'll show you how to do that now. All right. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to go to your domain provider. In my case, it's godaddy.com. So I went over there and I'm going to click on NextTech Consultants and I'm going to click DNS. What that's going to do is you need to manage your DNS records and put in a text entry. You'll see on mine, it's already there. VSPF1 include spfprotectionoutlook.com and this little squiggly line all. Now I'm going to link all of these in the description below. So all you have to do is copy and paste them in. But there are two most common ones are Outlook and Google. So I'm going to show them on the screen now. It's for the ones for Google. You can see it here. For the ones for Outlook, you can see here. And here's the other part. If you're using Mailchimp or a different provider to send emails, it's important to put that in also. So that way those emails flow properly. So in this case, if I wanted to put those in, I would click edit and you leave VSPF1 and you also leave include Outlook protection, little squiggly line, all. So then you just add whatever ones you need to add. And for Mailchimp, this will also be in the description below in case you need it, but it's servers.mcsv.net. And now I'm going to paste that in. And like I said, this will be in the description below. So all you have to do is copy and paste. But if you have Mailchimp or any other provider, make sure you include that here. And you're doing it with this second include statement after your first one. That's all you have to do. It's that easy. So once that's done, you're going to click save. And now any emails that go from Outlook or Mailchimp will now be authenticated in my domain and be more likely to bypass that spam filter. Now, if this helped you get your email set up better, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. It really does help me create more content like this that helps support your business. I hope this helped you and I look forward to seeing you next time. Thank you guys so much for joining me.